Christ's compassion. The Lord's healing hand is in your life. Two healthy children, and then a third child born with heart disease died in their parents' arms. After four miscarriages and being told that carrying a child to term is impossible, Andrew and Sandra Charney decide to adopt. On the way to Vietnam to pick up the adopted child, Sandra realizes she is pregnant. She returns with her adopted child and shortly after miraculously gives birth to another. Five children, 20 years of marriage, time to start winding down, right? In September 2006, the Canadian government called saying that their two nieces, one 16 and the other 11, had tragically lost their father a couple of years back, and are now being abused by their mother. They will have to be sent to an orphanage unless competent relatives are willing to take them in. Can we take care of two more children, especially children from these circumstances? How will they affect the family? Andrew and Sandra wonder, as they ponder what to do, the thought of their nieces becoming orphans overrides all rational calculations, and from the depths of their compassionate hearts, an act of generosity emerges: we accept. One act of generosity, however, does not automatically make for a smooth ride through life. Integrating Rain and Jackie into a home with parameters and a certain amount of discipline was not easy. They never lived that way before. Get up, go to school, study, turn things in on time, show courtesy and politeness, be back at a reasonable hour, oh, and Mass on Sunday. Mass? I don't even believe in God, says Rain, the 16-year-old. Sandra gently responds, we go to Mass as a family. If you don't want to participate, that's fine, all I ask is that you attend with respect. She agrees, as does Jackie. They push ahead, day by day, trying to create a united family. Summer comes and goes. A new school year begins, and along with it the yearly retreat at church, Rain decides to go. Who knows, maybe just to get a change of scenery for a couple days. 3 days later, however, she silently walks in the house, with a huge smile on her face. Is everything okay, Rain? Asks Sandra. Yes, she responds, holding a broken piece of wood. Look, I broke this piece of wood with my hands. Oh, I didn't know you knew karate. I don't, I broke it by the power of the Holy Spirit. Oh, look, when I left for the retreat, my life was broken like this board, then joining the two pieces back into one, she continues. Now God has put my life back together. On the joined pieces I could read, I love Jesus. She continues, remember when I told you that I don't believe in God? Well, now I do, and not only that, now I believe that Jesus Christ was crucified, and died to take away my sins, and give me a new life. During Easter of 2008, Rain will be adopted once again, but this time by God Himself through the sacraments of baptism and confirmation. She will be reconciled with her eternal Father who awaits her with arms outstretched. She will participate in full communion with her new family, the Church, through the sacrament of the Eucharist. Jackie is also taking CCD classes to prepare to receive her sacraments. Today we see Christ's compassion in healing the man born blind. The man may have been born blind, but he had perfect spiritual sight, a sight that led him to Jesus and a belief that he could place his hopes and fears at Christ's feet and Jesus would bring healing. Yes, the man's faith brought physical sight, but a sight that came to him through Jesus' compassion. Jackie and Rain both acquired faith and spiritual sight through the compassionate gift of family. Andrew and Sandra were Christ's healing and compassionate hands. Who will you reach out to today and touch with your faith and compassion? For each one of us, there is only one thing necessary, to fulfill our own destiny, according to God's will, to be what God wants us to be. Thomas Merton, no man is an island.